Guys, we're back. Another month of Patreon, full of fun, loving some good songs, hopefully.
You know what it is. You've been here. You know the drill. New music, new reactions. We're just excited.
Absolutely. So we're doing Joe Walsh.
Yeah, and he's from the Eagles, right?
That's what they've said. We looked it up. Wikipedia confirmed it. Exciting
awesome.
Stuff.
That's the equivalent of we read it on the internet, so we're going to go with it.
Yeah.
That being absolutely. Said, you know the song title, Rocky Mountain Way? Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Do we know the song title?
I don't know.
Either way, let's get into it. Really impressive tone already. Ooh.
They swung a little bit.
A little bit swung. I love that you picked that up. It does feel very Eagles. The snare reverb is amazing.
Yeah.
Oh my god. One little bass note.
Yeah. Drums. dude.
That's like a home run as far as rock songs are considered. At least to me. Holy cow. Wow.
That was a great song, dude.
Yeah, like I said, dude, home run. Home run.
Yeah. Joe Walsh. I never heard of him until, you know, YouTube and stuff. Crazy.
Which is weird because, I mean, this feels like the Eagles, but its own unique thing. Like, it feels like you boiled down one part of the Eagles.
Yeah. That like, blues rock, like, rooted part. Yeah. It was a rocker, dude. Yeah. So here's my thing. When it started, when it was doing its thing, I was like, okay, this is like a B right now, right? Yeah. And then just as the song progressed, I'm like, oh, okay, this is a B+.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, it's A minus. Yeah. And now I'm torn between A minus and A, but I'm pretty sure it's A for me.
I feel like I'm pretty sure it's A.
Like, I wouldn't argue anything less than A. Like, it's a great song. It's a great song.
I just love, like, the little production techniques that they used. Like, again, like the snare having some reverb, like, very tasteful, and it's only there if you're listening for it. Other than that, you just feel it, you don't hear it.
Yeah, and even though you liked it when it showed up, it still grows on you as the song goes, right? At the end of the song, when it's pulling shit back and you still have that, you're like, oh my God, I love that detail.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Guitar tone was impeccable. His vocal tone was impeccable. Not the best, like, singer, but he knew that, and so he did it in a way that was, charismatic.
Charisma, dude. And they had the whole, like, talk box and, like, organ keyboard thing going on and the mixes, you know? And then, like, my favorite part of the song was how they developed that right after, how they pulled it all back, and the snare started coming in, like, faster, and then it went back into the
groove. I loved how dynamic that drummer was. The drummer was maybe the best part of the song for me.
Really?
As far as... He's somebody who, I don't know who drummed in this, but he obviously has a very, very strong command on dynamics. Like, he would do things like towards the end where he'd hit the crash, like do like a forzando, like hit it and then go, and then hit another one, and just like, so he's like making these big waves in volume with just hitting the exact same stuff, which is super impeccable to me.
Yeah, he's like making the most out of the tools like that he has, you know? And it was super cool because especially when they were in that pulled back part with like the talk box and the like keyboard and stuff, because it's almost like you had three independent people working together because the guitar is doing its own thing a little bit, the keyboard is doing its own thing a little bit, and then the snare, there were certain parts in it, rhythmically where he's kind of like,
doing his own stuff thing.
So it's like three independent parts, but like, oh, like, we're all together.
Like, yeah. Where it's like they've all got this internal clock where they're like, each one of them is like, all right, I'm going to go off a little bit on this part, and then you go off a little bit on a different part, and we're all going to be together, but sort of not together.
But they're like coordinated, but they all come back. And it's like, that I thought was probably the coolest part, but then the part right after that where it built up.
Yeah.
Great song. It was a rocker. It's a rocker, dude.
It's a banger.
Rocker.
It's a banger. So I guess A. I guess we're rating it A.
A. So first Joe Walsh song, seeing somebody from the Eagles showing up, spitting out flames on his name.
So normally we ask you guys, tell us your, like, the next song we should listen to. But I want you to also tell us, more so than that, do you prefer Joe Walsh or the Eagles? Which one is your go-to? Like, if you're putting on one of them in the car, which is it? Because I'm curious.
Depends.
Well, I feel like we don't have enough to say yet. We've only heard one Joe Walsh song.
We've heard
a bunch of Eagles.
That's very true.
You know?
From what I've heard right now, it's like if you have your girlfriend in the car, play the Eagles. If you have your guy in the car, it seems like you played this kind of stuff.
Very maybe.
Which isn't a bad thing at all. But it just seems like that. But like we said, we haven't heard much Joe Walsh at all, so...
Let us know. We'll see you next video.